This
Okay.
conference will now be recorded.
Yeah. Tell me, what is your issue?
Can you go to MD04, please?
Okay. Material code.
Material
Any
is
color? Yeah. Okay.
bicycle, BYC. No,
Yeah.
bicycle RR, the second one.
Okay. Okay.
Click now.
Yeah.
And now I release the order. Can you click to? I mean, it's look here, everything is okay. But
Yeah, correct.
when I go to MIGO in the first order
Okay.
260, you can copy it and you can go
Okay.
to MIGO.
Okay. Yesterday I told you na somewhere this default setting is not coming, goods receipt. That is the
So,
reason you are getting the issue.
yeah, when I go
One minute.
to MIGO and it gave
Okay.
me some error. If you,
Yeah. Yeah, that error is because
yeah,
of the tick
hi,
mark only.
Mr. Vasu.
Yeah, hi Nicholas, good morning.
Yeah, good evening. I apologize. Good
Yeah.
morning. I apologize. Sorry about that.
Okay, no problem. No problem. Okay. Okay. I am checking where is that setting. Because that auto GR is not coming automatically. So I'm checking. Confirmations.
Second.
Yeah, okay.
But if you go to MIGO, we can check over there.
Yeah, correct. Actually, this tick mark automatic is missing. That is the reason actually this item is relevant to the indicators. Okay. Settlement. This is also some costing issue. Let me see. Because of this settlement profile. This casting people, somebody they are changing actually.
Okay, we'll check now if you see.
I don't know what. Somebody is doing practice, they are changing.
Yeah.
The reason is when you enter this order, okay, and press all these details, you are getting one empty screen. This is correct. Maintain settlement rule.
Go back.
Yeah, because of this, the issue is coming actually. Okay. Let me manually maintain. Okay, but temporarily you need to do manually only.
Yeah, but
that
if
means
you go to MIGO, I will see now.
I understood your issue. Okay,
yes.
I can show you goods receipt, correct?
Yeah.
This is order.
Goods issue, you can do the goods issue.
Goods issue. Okay.
Yeah. And the order 100. Or 260, no, 260, no, this is not the one. 00, 260, yeah, that's 260, yeah, that's the one.
Okay. Not
now,
contain
so
any selected items.
Does not contain, document does not contain correct data, so I don't.
Not correct data, no items. That means go to CO03. You are doing goods issue. Goods issue means components you want to issue.
Right.
Okay, go to the components. Here, the component is bicycle handle.
Yeah.
Okay. Now, but you made this as a backflush active.
Okay.
So if you activate the backflush, you cannot, you should not do in MIGO. Backflush means auto goods issue. You need to do that in confirmation only. Order confirmation, CO11N and CO15 is there. That time automatically this issue will happen.
So when I use good issue, good issue, you want me to take the backflush off from the.
Exactly. So let me do the change here itself. Change, enter. I'm going to the components, remove this tick mark, backflush. Okay. I'm just removing it and save it. Clear?
Yeah.
Hello?
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah.
Save it.
Yeah.
I'm just saving it. So then now you can go to MIGO and you can check it. Goods issue, order, execute. Now you got this.
So the check mark was in the material master, not supposed
to
be.
Correct. If check mark is there, goods issue, you need to do in the confirmation. If the check mark is not there, you can do goods issue in MIGO.
I see.
Okay. Clear?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay. Any other doubts?
No, this one I was trying to locate and it was not work out.
Okay. Fine. Good. Okay. Nicholas, do you have any questions?
No, thanks a lot, Mr. Rashimo. I don't have any question.
Nicholas.
But what we did yesterday, it is clear.
Okay.
So, but I didn't practice yet because now we will have some issue. Is the company fix it now and the plant fix it since yesterday or not?
No, no.
Because, no, okay, okay, no problem.
Okay. Okay. So, can I start today's topic?
Yes.
Yeah, okay. So, today's topic is long-term planning.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay. What is long-term planning? We'll see. Okay. Name itself, we can see long-term planning, but that means it is a future planning. If you say future means maybe after 6 months, after 1 year, or next year, or next 5 years. Okay, how is your planning? Planning in the sense of your raw material. Okay, raw material means, for example, you take the example of a car, Honda car. Okay, Honda car engine is manufacturing in Japan. Engine is coming from Japan and assembling is in US. Okay, engine is assembling in Japan, so that means from Japan to US, if you want to bring the engine from Japan to US, maybe you need 2 weeks or 3 weeks. It will take only transport. Correct?
Yeah.
Transport is 2 weeks, example. And to produce this engine, production, maybe 2 weeks. Okay, production and moving that material from plant to shipyard, and from shipyard to your US, maybe it is taking 1 month, for example, total complete 4 weeks. Okay, now you want to plan this material, Honda car, next week. You have an order next week. Next week means maybe a 20th, or maybe today's 15th. You want one order on 15th. So is it possible to manufacture that on 15th?
No.
No, because to manufacture a Honda car, you need an engine. If you need an engine, it will take 1 month. So that means you need to procure 1 month before. Like this, you will have these kind of materials in your production. This is one example I told you. Some materials may be taking 6 months also to come that material to your location because of its manufacturing or because of something else. Okay, so those materials you want to check and you want to generate purchase orders for them, you need a long-term plan. You need a long-term planning for that. Okay, so one is to plan your raw materials, future demand, raw material, future demand. According to that future demand, you will start procuring now itself. You won't wait.
Can we use FERT material or?
Yeah, any material. I will tell you what is that material. Example, you have a plan of Honda cars next month or in future. There is a festival in US, so there is a chance to sell more cars in during that, maybe a June fest or August fest. Okay, so that time, example, you want to sell 100 cars. Okay, so that means you need 100 engines. How many engines you need? 100 engines I need to procure. Okay, so that means you will do the long-term planning for Honda car, based on that Honda car, you will come to know how much demand you need for this raw material. Okay? So that is first point. The advantages, features of long term is raw material feature demand you will come to know. Okay, without, okay. Second thing is capacity situation.
Yeah, one more question.
Yeah.
When long term planning is could be liquid, could be kerosene, could be gas, could be fertilizer or anything, they
yes.
all go in long material. Is
Correct.
the same scenario that you are working, or everyone has a different, like discrete and process and repeated?
No, there is no difference for discrete or PPPA.
I see. So long-term planning could be any kind of material, right?
Yes, correct.
I see. Okay.
This is for any kind of material.
Okay. Okay.
Okay.
Okay. Capacity situation.
Now, yeah. Second thing is capacity situation. Okay. Capacity situation means you have done the capacity planning, correct? CM01 and CM21. Okay. CM01 is capacity evaluation. So if in future you want to produce 100 cars, do you have the capacity? It will check. You want to check, do I have the capacity to produce 100? This marketing people, they told there is a fest in US, they want to sell 100 cars. Mm-hmm. But really, to manufacture 100 cars, do we have a capacity in August?
So you can create a capacity CM01?
No, I will tell you how to do that one. So these are the features actually. You can do, or you can check what is the capacity situation. Okay, these two are the main advantages of this long-term planning. Okay, one is your raw material procurement situation, second is the capacity. Okay, capacity situation. So then now, these long-term planning in real time, actually, what will happen is, first, your marketing people will say, marketing person, this long term planning is involved a different people, not the single person decision. Okay, this long term planning in business will be decided by the group of people. Okay, for example, first marketing, he will say in August, I can sell Honda cars. Okay, 1,000 he will say. Okay, 1,000. So then sales person will come in the same August. Okay, marketing is saying 1,000. But as a salesperson, I can sell only 900. I cannot sell 1,000. This is another value salesperson is giving. Okay. Now, third person, actually the manufacturer. Manufacturer means who is the shop floor person, production guy. Or you can say production person. He will come. And in August, I can produce only 800 only. I cannot produce 1,000 because, I cannot produce. This is produce production. Mm-hmm. Okay, 800 only I can produce because my capacity will saying only 800 is available. Mm-hmm. Okay, that means you have a large demand, you have a huge demand, but I cannot produce. My mission capacity is only 800. Okay, so these three people will argue how much they can produce and everything. Okay, and next is, after these people, another manager will come, means who is the boss of all these three people. Okay. Or you can say top management. This person will come and decide. He will argue with all these three people. Because top management always look for a profit. How much profit I can gain. Okay. Production person always looks how much he can produce. Sales person looks for how much I can sell. Okay. All these, this top management person will come and he will ask, okay, production person is saying 800. How can I make this 800 to 900 in the August? What are the possibilities? Okay. What are the possibilities? He will ask the production person. So he has to tell why only 800. What are the other possibilities? Other possibilities like you need to increase the manpower. Presently we are working 12, maybe 14 hours. If you want to produce 900 or 1000, people has to work 20 hours.
So in other words, when the marketing person, sales person, and these are four persons, they anticipate, means they have intention, or they have a plan to sell or produce 1900 or something like this. Is that correct?
Correct. Marketing person is projecting 1000 because there is a festival. Festival in August. So there is a chance he can sell by discounts or something else. Okay, he can sell 1000, he is saying. But salesperson is arguing, okay, you are a marketing person, you are telling 1000, but really it won't happen that much. It will be only 900. Because last year also we sold only 900. He argue it. Okay. Now production is okay. 900 is your sell sold last year, so we can sell this year 1000 also. But production guy is telling I have only 800 capacity. Okay. Now manager has come and he is telling what are the possibilities to make from 800 to 900. Possibilities is like increase capacity means presently work is happening in 14 hours. If we increase to 20 hours, I can produce 900. Okay.
Yeah.
So these discussions will happen in a meeting. Okay, with all the stakeholders in a management. Okay, and finally they will come to a conclusion that this is final. Okay, final value means final sales, final projections. Okay, final value, they come to a example like maybe a 900 with capacity increase. Okay, capacity, with the capacity increase we will achieve 900 in the August. This is the planning how it will happen. Okay, this process is called long-term planning, but in SAP we won't do all these things, marketing, sales and person. This is out of SAP, these discussions and everything will happen. Okay, now these are assumption values, correct? Marketing is saying 1000 and sales is saying 900, production 800, finally 900. These are the assumptions. This so in SAP we will call this as a simulation version.
Simulation. Simulation.
Simulation version, that means this data we are simulating, we are not actual data. If you put actual data means it will create actual planned order, production order and everything. But it is not a actual data. We are just simulating all this data. How this production guy told 800? He has simulated something. That simulation, how we will do, we will check it now. Okay. So this long-term planning is nothing but a simulation. It is not actual planning. Okay. Actual values. This is called the simulation. Simulation means test data. Once it is final, if you want, you can move this is into a final data.
But you can
before final.
But the final is the simulation data, but the before final is not simulation.
No. Before final is the simulation data. This is everything is simulation. Okay. You can say these are the simulation values. And final, if you find, okay, we have decided 900 is fine. So then you will make this is actual data. Okay.
I see.
How to make from simulation to actual also, I will show you now. Is it clear?
Yeah.
Okay. Now, I am going to the system now. What are the setup and everything we'll see. I am going to use, okay, you have created the bicycle, correct?
Mm-hmm.
MD04RR, you have, okay, all independent requirements, everything you have. MD04 for Honda. Car one, let me see. Okay, I have some orders. I will clean up this one, okay? Then I will show you the scenario. Clean up means I am removing everything here. MD62. Just I want to remove everything actually. Okay. So then you will clearly see the results actually. MD04. I am deleting these orders also. I am deleting it. Nicholas, any questions till now?
No, Mr. Vasu, I'm following up. Yeah.
Yeah, okay. You understood the concept, long-term planning?
Yes. Usually we make it in some company, like in APO, we make it like for 2 years maybe. Is that right?
Yeah, correct. So actually this complete, if you need more features, more advanced, then we will use the APO for this long-term plan.
Okay.
If you don't want that, you want to see the general thing, so you can use long-term planning in S4 or ECS.
Correct.
Okay.
Yeah.
I am using this Honda Car 1 material. There is no data now. Okay. So what are the data and what are the steps you need, we will see. Okay. First thing is master data. You don't require any specific master data. Okay. Can be used normal master data. You don't require any specific settings or nothing is required. Okay. Okay, I can say one thing actually. Okay, I will show you only one setting which is there in work center actually. I am opening the work center WC3001001. Go to the capacities, and if you go to the header details of this capacity header, here you can see one tick mark, long-term planning.
Yes.
Okay, this tick mark should be there.
Yes.
To check your capacities.
So when you work in the long term, this should be checked out.
Correct, correct.
Can be
Okay.
used. Yeah.
I can say tick
You
mark
can
work
mention
center.
here, yeah, work center
Okay.
in capacity tab
Yeah.
in the bottom line.
Capacity
Capacity
header
header.
details screen. Activate
or check marks
or check mark.
Yeah.
Check mark long term planning. Okay, this is only the setting you can do specific to long term plan. Other things, existing material, you can use it. Okay, now what are the steps you need to do? Process steps. Okay, first thing is I will show you the navigation path now. So logistics, production, expand production planning. Under this you can see long term planning.
Yeah.
Okay. First step is you need to create a scenario.
I see.
This is the first step.
MS-31?
Okay. Yeah, I'm writing here. Create scenario. Transaction code is MS-31. Okay. So open this scenario. So this MRP planning scenario means using this scenario like simulation I told you. Okay. Like simulation using this is nothing but a scenario. Okay. Using this scenario, you will work. Okay. Based on the scenario number only you are going to work now. Okay, so now here what are the things you need to enter is just a one number here, any 3-digit number and the description. Okay, for example any 3-digit number, earlier this is only there. Okay, I can create anything. For example, I am creating a scenario. Next, this is year.
ABC.
Yeah. Only numbers. It won't take the
number.
This one. Yeah.
1910 or 011.
Only 3 digits it will take. Okay. Example. Okay. I'm taking 100. Start with 100. Okay. So and description. Planning. First. August.
Yeah.
Example. Okay. For August 2019, I am doing the planning.
And you should be check the radio long term planning grass.
Yeah, correct. This is automatically will come. If you want, you can select also. For example, I will take July only. Okay, July planning for July 2019. That is my planning scenario.
Okay.
Press enter. Okay, I will put August only. We'll
yeah.
see. Okay, and press enter. Once you press enter, this screen will come. Create planning scenario control data. Okay. So here, what we will do is first, you want to do the planning for what is the start date and end date.
August.
You can give here any date. Planning, you start and end anything you can give. Okay.
This will not be a dates as you mentioned in August
are not required. If you want to keep the same thing like August, you can keep it, but it is not a mandate. You can put the your horizon.
Can you change the status? It says not released.
It will get automatically changed once you save it.
I see.
Okay, so first thing is here you enter the start and end dates.
Okay.
So then next, planned independent requirements, PIRs. Okay. So what is PIRs means? I told you 1000 in the August, correct? This is nothing but the independent requirement. Okay. This independent requirement you want to create for which simulation version, simulation version. Okay, that you will assign it here. Okay, so here click plan independent requirements first. This small pop-up box will come. Here click on add button, new entry. Here select any one of the versions, like example simulation version. These are the actual simulations. Against this number only we are going to work. Okay, for example I am taking the 02 simulation. Okay, select this, and this simulation version you can enter the date. For example, you want to keep any August or something, you can keep it valid.
First August, for example.
First August, okay. And enter.
10 August.
End of this August, you can say. Oh, okay. Enough. So okay. This version, you want to make it for only August.
Okay. What is the T?
T.
Time.
Yeah. You are able to hear me?
Yeah, a sign comes as a expense network connection difficulty.
Okay. Okay. So that means target version means you, once the simulation is over, we are doing as a simulation.
Okay.
Okay. After simulation, you want to make into actual version. What is that actual version? Okay. You can maintain it here, otherwise we will do it there. Okay. Okay. Now here only the version, simulation version number, and from date and to date. Okay, and you can click on confirm. You can, you need to remove remember this simulation version 02. Okay, I'm writing it, simulation version 02, and our planning scenario number, planning scenario is 100. Just numbers, these are okay. Now you can click on confirm. Is it clear? This setting, radio button.
Yeah.
Okay, next, this is scenario you want to use in which plant. You need to assign that plant. Here you can see second button is plant. Okay, you click this button, click plus button, new entry, and this is scenario you want to use in any plant. Those plants you can note down here. Not only single plant, you want to add one more plant, you can add it.
I see.
Okay, so and click confirm. Is it clear? We have added the second step, plants. Okay. Now, once your settings are completed, you feel that independent requirements is over and plants is over, then finally you need to release it. That is the third step. Release plus save it. So once you release it, this status will be changed to release. Okay. Release plus save. Once is released, you can only change the independent requirements indicators. So that means once you release, you cannot change some settings. Okay. So do you want to release? Yes. Immediately. Okay. So you can come back. It is saying under this plant, there is this many materials are available. Okay. So if you come back, oh, sorry, you can see. You want to display that scenario, MS-33 is the display. You select that scenario 100 and press enter. Now you can see the status.
Released, yeah.
Okay. This is the main setup here.
Okay.
you don't require any other setup.
Now this is the scenario for 1000 car, but if you go for the second scenario, then you can do the same ways for the second.
Yeah, if you want to, that is the reason. For example, the scenario you created from 1 to 1 minute, you want to use the same scenario, okay? For example, these dates you want to change for next quarter, from August to you want to August, August, September, October, till October you want to use it. You can change the date and you can use it.
Yeah,
not only August. If you want to, yeah. Yes.
My
please.
Point is, can you go to Excel sheet, please?
Yes.
My point is, this scenario you're talking about 1,000 car, right?
Correct.
So if we go to second scenario, means we can go to simulation second for the 900 and then 800?
No. This everything is we are doing for month, this month only.
Or August.
Okay, I will tell you, yeah.
But all there, these, the other one is also in August.
Correct. These are the different persons only.
I see.
These are different persons.
Okay.
Okay. And actually, if you want to make different versions also, you can make it. I will show you. Okay.
So
you
every
want
person,
to make every person is having the one scenario. Okay. That also is possible. Okay. I will, for example, this marketing person is 02. Okay. 02 version. And this person is 03 version. And what else we have? That is also we can do. Go to the planning. And what are the others? Just click on plus button and you can add 4 is also there. Okay, I'm adding it.
3.
Okay, 3 and 4. Okay, these are the 4 versions. Okay, 3 versions. Okay, and you want to one more top management is another version. Okay,
which
production plan? Yeah, 5 I will take. Okay, and you can put the dates here. Okay, all versions we are entering 2, 3, 4, 5 and save it. We saved all the versions. Let me check once again. Okay, all the versions we saved it. Now in the Excel file I am going to 03 and this is 04 and this is 05. Okay, is it clear? Okay, this is final version. Final version is 05. Okay, now this is a setup. First create scenario. The next is you need to maintain independent requirements for all these versions, correct? This 1000, 900 and 800. These you need to maintain. Okay, where you maintain is, these are 1900, 800 is nothing but your planned independent requirements. Okay, what is the transaction code generally you will use for planned independent requirement?
MD61.
Correct. Here also use the MD61. Okay, now I will open that MD61. We are using the material code Honda Car 1. Okay, so now I am going to this MD61 transaction code and we will see how to maintain these different versions. So here you can see planned independent requirements, MD61. Okay, now here you can see, you can enter the material whenever you open this transaction code. Maybe you observed or not, this is the version you will know. Correct? 00 is the active version. Active means which is the real version. Remaining all are only simulations only. As per SAP standard, 00 is only the active version. Okay, remaining all are dummy versions, you can say.
Sorry, 00 active version, you said active?
Yes, active. Okay. Real version.
Okay.
So remaining all are your dummy versions only.
Simulation. Yeah.
Okay. For example, if you remove this one, because you want to maintain the values in different versions, okay, you remove that one and press enter. Press enter. Okay, you can keep everything and press enter. Is it mandatory? Oh, it is mandatory. It is asking, okay, I will enter 00 and press enter. Okay, once you enter here, why these values are there? Let me delete it. Okay, now in this screen, generally against this material, you are entering all values, correct? Okay, now we are working in a long term planning. You can enter your version, like same material code here. Okay, and here change the version. 02, this person is from marketing. Okay, he told in the month of August 1000, you enter that 1000. Okay, and same material, Honda car. Okay, and version 03, person is from sales, he told 900. Okay, Honda person, same 04 production person, he is saying 800. Like this you can maintain actually. Okay, is it clear?
Yeah.
Save it.
Yes.
Yeah, save it. You have saved it. Okay, if you want to check the same data, you can go to the change mode or display mode, and you can enter specific to version, select version or all active and inactive versions. You can use this button in display or change mode, all active and inactive versions here, and press enter. It will show you all data. Okay, all data it will show you. Is it clear?
Yes.
Now these people are, these are the proposals from these three people that we maintain, and finally you come to a conclusion that you want to manufacture 900 only. So that final version is 05. Okay, that is 05, or I can say for change purpose, I will put this is as 875. Okay, finally they concluded with all possibilities, 875 only they can manufacture. Okay, so now this final version we will maintain it. Final version, you can say, you can create. Can I put it here? Okay. So your version, final version is 05, and against the 05, you can decide 875 is your final value.
What is the other one? X9?
Maybe something. Actually, for testing purpose, earlier I created it.
I see.
You don't require this now. Okay, in this plant.
Yeah, but it will not give error because there is no.
Yeah, it won't give. It won't give any error. Do you want to delete select? Yeah, okay. You can delete. Okay. So you understood this one? clear, and save it. 05 is your final version. Save it. Now you decided 875 is your production final version. So you want to check now how much is with 875, how much is your raw material, how much is your capacity situation with 875. You want to see that one. Okay, to see these two things, what you need to do is you need to run MRP, correct? With MRP only you can see the capacity and raw material planning, correct? So here you need to run MRP. Yes, tell me.
MD01N.
Yeah, I'm coming that MRP run.
Yeah.
Okay, so this long-term planning is having the different transaction codes.
I see.
You will have a different transaction code for MRP. All this long-term planning, correct?
I see.
So the transaction codes starting with MS means it is related to long-term plan.
I see.
Okay. Starting with MRP is starting with MS means it is a long-term plan. So to MRP run in long-term planning, you can use like MD01 N is there. Okay, HANA. So like that, you can use MS01.
MS01.
Yeah, N is not there. And you have the another transaction code MS02. MS01 is for the all materials in a plant, okay, or you can say mass MRP, or for a complete plant and everything. MS02 is like individual single material. Okay, so here you need to use the transaction code MS02. So now I will show you this in path. Here you can see in the long term planning, here you can see single item plan. In normal also it is MD02 is there, one more transaction code like MD01N, MD02 is there. So in place of MD02, here is a transaction MS02. Okay, open this transaction code. Here you need to enter your planning scenario. This is scenario we created in first. Okay, so all your planning situation, everything we will check with these two values only, planning scenario and simulation. Okay, based on these two we will check everything. Okay, so now once you open this MRP screen, you will see the planning scenario, material and plant. Okay, and here scheduling mode, you need to select the second one, lead time scheduling and capacity planning. To know about your capacity planning, you need to use the lead time scheduling.
Now this is a transaction code is MRP.
Correct.
Oh, MS01. Oh,
MS02. MS02.
Okay.
Okay. Now, before this, if you want to see the details, which transaction you will use, forecast, planned order and everything, you will use MD04, correct? MD04.
Right.
Correct. So now you can see MD04. Okay. So the situation
we have to create, like you have something with the version. Here it
Yeah,
show
yeah.
all the version. Yeah.
Yeah, I'm coming actually. Okay,
Yeah.
so actually you want to see same kind of transaction MD04. In long term planning, you have another transaction code that is called the MS04.
Yeah.
Like MD04, you have another transaction called MS04. Okay, once you open this transaction, you can see long term stock requirement list. Okay, and here you can see MRP planning scenario 100. So initial starting point itself is 100 is our scenario. Actually, it is showing everything. Okay, so what you need to do is actually, okay, I am going to the
confirm
MD.
One of them. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah, correct. MD62.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
What we did, all Act 1 NY and Act 2 versions. Mm-hmm. Okay. Here, these data is for discussion purpose. Correct? During the meeting time, different people proposed the different versions. Now, final version is like this one. 875, it is concluded. So before doing the planning run, you can remove these values. That means once the meeting is completed, you remove these values. Otherwise, it is coming all wrong data. Okay, you remove these values. So finally, you keep only the version, final version 05, and save it. Okay, now if you see the MS04, you can see only the independent requirement. This is the final requirement for you.
So you clean all of them, just leave one of them, right?
Yeah, correct. Which is the final decision value. Okay, this is a final decision value. Now based on this, I want to check how much is my capacity situation and what are the components you need. To do that one, you need to run the MRP. So the transaction code is MS02. So let me run this one, MS02. This is MS02 transaction code. You enter scenario, whatever we created, material and planned. And then you need to change the scheduling only, because we are doing the capacity also check. Same thing like in MD01N also, you will have the scheduling. We'll put that is as a 2, same, okay? And then press enter. Okay, you can see simulative planned orders. It is not planned order. Simulative planned orders are created. These are not actual planned orders, okay? MRP is over. Now once again check MD04. MD04 means your MS04. So here I am writing LTP, long term planning stock requirements list. This is nothing but a MS04. Like your MD04, this is MS04. Now, if you go and see in this transaction, if you want to see the path, go to the evaluations here and you can see where is this, the stock requirements list. And this list is with respect to scenario 100, material planned, and press enter. Now you can see you got the planned order. Okay. Now, as you got the planned order, can we convert this into production order?
Yes. Yeah. Maybe you have to make the evaluation, no? Capacity evaluation or not necessarily?
Yeah. First thing is, this is a simulation. We are not doing actual data.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Simulation with respect to scenario 100. Okay. So you cannot convert this into the planned order. This is not a real planned order. You can see
Simulation.
there is no butter conversion. This is everything is a simulation only. Okay, real means this planned order should appear in MD04. MD04 is your real. Here you can see that planned order is not there. If you see in MD04 real stock requirements list, that means that is a real. Still it is not a real. Okay. So you cannot, first thing is long term planning, planned orders, you cannot convert into production order. Those are not for real production. This is still under the evaluation. Evaluation means decision taking. Okay. So now that is first point. Now I am going to this planned orders. Fine. Very good. Now you want to see the situation of your components. Ignite this one. Okay. You can enter your tire and you can press enter. You can see simulation requirement. So you need around 4,375 tires in the month of August to manufacture this planned order. This is simulation requirement. You will come to know how much you can procure it. This simulation requirement you cannot see in real. Based on the simulation, you need to take your decisions. Okay. So tire simulation has come. So like this, what are the materials you required as per the August planning? You can see here. This simulation is not real. Okay. How to make this as a real? I will tell you. Still we are in a simulation. This is first point. Okay. First point means purpose of this long term planning. This is first. Correct. This understood raw material future demand.
Yeah.
Okay. Now next is capacity situation. So to check your capacity, generally what is the transaction you will use?
CM01 evaluation.
CM01. Okay. That is called the capacity evaluation. Okay. But in long term for same CM01. Capacity. No. You will use another transaction called CM38 is the transaction for capacity evaluation. Okay. Purpose is same, but transaction code is different. Let me open in a path. So here in path, in evaluations only here, you can see CM38. Capacity requirements CM38. Okay, you can open this transaction code. Generally, when you open this transaction code, you will see only work center capacity and plant only. But whenever you are using in the long term planning, you will see the scenario also. Okay, this is the additional field because based on that scenario only, we are running our planning. Okay, so you need to put your scenario 100 and work center and plant and press enter. Then now you can see the situation whether it is 100% or overloaded. You can see here.
Oh, it's perfect. 100%.
Yeah,
I mean, how you can figure out from here?
You can see this is your requirement, this is available capacity, and this is your capacity load percentage. If it is 100 means it is perfect.
Yeah.
Okay. If we have a different values, overload means around 200% or around 150% is there. That means you are overloaded.
Can I ask a question? How come it come like this? Because we put the production in August only for 1 month. You know? So So does mean we start the production before?
This WorkCenter is used for other purpose also, in other materials.
Okay. Yeah.
Because
yeah,
of
yeah,
that
yeah,
came
yeah.
actually.
Yeah.
Okay. Let me.
Yeah.
But this is how you can see your details actually.
Yeah. But I see the Honda car. It is here, there. You know, from
13.5
to 28. Yes. Exactly. Yeah.
Correct. So
this one maybe Mr. Wasu, this one what we fixed the last time, you know, we make a what is called leveling capacity.
Yeah, leveling. But here only you can see the capacity situation. There is no leveling here, long-term plan.
Okay.
You will come to know that means leveling is nothing but, for example, you planned 875, for example. Okay,
yeah.
It is a overload here. You planned 875. If it is a overload here, then you need to reduce that quantity from 875 to 850. You need to put because you don't have the sufficient capacity.
Mm-hmm.
That way you need to do. But in the leveling, you cannot do, because in actual leveling means you are moving the orders.
Yeah.
Okay. Moving the orders to next day or next week or like that. But here, this is a simulation. We are not moving anything. You need to reduce or you need to increase your working hours.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Working hours.
Now, when you do this planning, long-term planning, can you do it one more time, but not the back and forth here, just straight? That we can see it.
Okay. I think if you practice yourself, that is good actually. If I do the second time, it won't affect you actually. Okay.
Yeah.
I can finish in 5 minutes also. Okay, no problem.
Okay.
Now, is it clear this concept and everything?
Yes.
Okay.
Absolutely. Yeah.
Almost we understand about 90%. Just need the practice.
Yeah, correct. Okay. Now, you saw the capacity evaluation. You find that capacity is also 100% good.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Now, you want to make this as a real version. Real version means you want to confirm this. I am fine. In August, I am going to manufacture 875 is fine.
Okay.
That is called the operation planning or real planning. So that means how you can make this into the real planning.
That's the final step.
Correct. That is the final step. Okay. So real planning means your planned order should appear in MD04. Okay. For Honda example, Honda car one. So there is only the independent requirement. You are not executed anything for here. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So final means your planned order should appear in MD04. That is a final. Otherwise, till that time, only the simulation version only. Okay. So now how to make this as a final means you need to use the transaction code, independent requirement. Yeah. You need to use the copy version.
MS64.
Okay, that is the last step. MS64, it is nothing but a copy from simulation version to active version. Okay. Copy from simulation version to active. Simulation version is your 05. Active version is 002. Okay. I will show you how to make this. Open this transaction code. Very simple. Enter plant. Enter material. Okay. And here you can see version. Source version. Your source is 05. This is finally management decided 875. So that is nothing but a 0.5. Okay, your target is always a 0.0.
I see.
Okay, always target is always 0.0. Select this. Okay, and at the end, last of this transaction code, right. Here you can see no database changes simulation. You remove this check mark. It is like test mode. If you activate this, means it is a test mode. We are not testing.
Okay. Okay? So take the check mark off.
Yeah, check mark off. Okay. So, and then you check mark this one, output option, results list. So you can see that. See here.
Yeah.
Okay. You execute now. Now here you can see item successfully transferred. One item is transferred.
The last
Any
one
errors,
was,
no error.
Yeah, the last one check mark was there, right? Or did you take it out?
Yeah, it is there.
Okay.
It is there. Okay. Yeah. Results. That is the reason you got the results.
Yeah.
Okay.
Now
this is executed. And here you can see successfully transferred one, means one plan dot is transferred. If we expand this button, you can see the details. In the month of August, there is a 875 quantity is there, it is transferred. Okay. Now, if you go and see in MD04, now, where is that? Where is that?
Reset.
It should come. What happened? Requirement 0.5 0.0.
About write history
results, no change. Execute transfer one. One minute. So right there.
It is transfer it, yes. To platinum. I see the green.
Yeah, it is saying it is transferred actually.
Okay, but now we can see it in MD04, I believe. Is that right or not?
Yeah, it should come actually. It is not coming. I don't know. MD04. It is.
Oh.
Only independent requirement is copied actually. 875.
Yeah. Now with double it. Not now. It's double it. One more time.
Yeah. I'm deleting it. This I can delete. Okay. Sorry, the transfer is actually the 00, this one, 875.
Yeah,
earlier this is there for, do you want to save? Let me open it. 1 minute. Why it is showing you 2 times? Sorry, I will remove. Yeah, sorry. Okay, transfer is, this independent requirement is got transferred. Earlier, do we maintain this in 00 version? If you go to here MD62, it is transferred as active actually. I'm selecting all active and inactive versions. Press enter. Where is that 00? It should come here actually. Actually, from 05, this value should come to 00. Okay, I will once again transfer, we will see it. Okay, because our planning is dependent on this 00 version. So I will once again transfer, we will see from 05 to, it should transfer to 00. Let me doing once again copy version, and your source is 05 and target is 00, and remove the database changes, no database changes, results, execute. So it is showing you one is transferred, and then if you go to the MD62, select all active and inactive versions. Now you can see. Okay, so your simulation data is copied to your actual version.
Okay,
is it clear? Any?
Yeah, it is clear, but it's it should be in a sequence that go step by step. Back and forth, okay.
But concept is clear.
Concept is clear, yeah.
Yeah, if you practice once, it will come in a sequence only. Yeah. But again, I can show you in the next class.
Yes, okay? Yes.
One by one, just okay. I will show it to you.
Yeah, one by one. Yeah, okay. Go back and forth. Just stay one by one like this.
Okay. So this is long-term planning. Okay. Clear?
Okay, yes, sir. Clear.
Yeah.
Everything is clear.
Okay. Thank you. I think today we stretch another half an hour actually. Okay.
Yeah, no problem.
Okay. Yeah, okay. So next class is your Monday evening, correct?
Yeah. Yeah.
So by that time, just practice, complete all our scenarios and everything. If you have any questions, we will discuss.
Sure.
Okay.
Sure.
Thanks.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, everyone. Bye. Have a nice night. Bye.
You too. Bye. Thank you.